So we don't believe in the next life just to avoid this consequence. But that will not excuse us. We have to accept a type of body. Otherwise, how? There are so many different types of bodies. What is the explanation? Why different forms of body, different stages of body, different standard of body? There is nature's law. Therefore, this human form of life should be properly utilized, not simply engaged in sense gratification like cats and dogs. That is not very responsible life. Responsible life is that I have got this improved form of life than the cats and dogs, and I have got more intelligence than the cats and dogs. If I simply utilize it for four bodily necessities of life, four bodily necessities of life means we require some eating. The cats, dogs, human beings, or high court judge or anyone, they require some eating. They require sleeping, apartment. So that is, cats and dogs can sleep without apartment. But the sleeping required, that is fact. Eating required, that is fact. And sex life, that is also fact. And defense, that is also fact. But these things are common to the cats and dogs and man, human being. So what is the special feature of the human being? The special feature of the human being is that a human being can consider that I have got this nice American and Australian and Indian body, then what I am going to get next? What kind of body? That is utilized for human intelligence. A cat and dog cannot think like that. Therefore, our business should be, now by the nature's way, I have come to this form of life, by evolutionary process. Now I have got good intelligence, how I shall utilize it? You are cultivating knowledge, the ultimate goal of knowledge, Krishna says, is to know me. Vedaishta sarvai aham eva vedam. The whole knowledge is meant for understanding God. That is the end of knowledge. By progressive knowledge, you can make progress, but unless you do not come to the point to understand what is God, then your knowledge is imperfect. That is called Vedanta. Hathata Brahma Jigyasa. This human form of life, nice facility, intelligence, just like Australia was undeveloped since the Europeans came here. It is now very developed, resourceful, because the intelligence has been utilized. Mayadhakshena prakriti swayate sacharatam. Nature is a machine. So do you think a machine works without an operator? Do you think? Is there any evidence? Now this is a machine, photography, a wonderful machine. It is taking the picture and it will move. But there is an operator. Where is the machine which is working without operator? Can you give any example? Here is a machine which is working without operator. So how do you think that the nature machine is working without the supreme operator, God's instruction? How do you think it? This is not very reasonable. We have to judge. There are different evidences. One of the evidence is hypothesis. That hypothesis is that because we see that no machine works without operator, therefore we should conclude it, even though we do not know what is God, what is the nature, we must conclude it that the nature is working under some supreme operator, that is God. It is not necessary to see the operator, but we can guess that there must be operator. The human life is meant for finding out who is there to operate. That is human life. Otherwise, it's cats and dogs' life. They're eating, sleeping, mating, and dancing, that's all. That is not human life. You must find out who is the operator. Athāta brahma jigyāsa, this is called in Sanskrit word. Now this human form of life is meant for inquiring about the supreme operator. Now that supreme operator, Krishna, is so kind. He is giving evidence in the Bhagavad Gita. Mayā dhakṣena prakṛti śyate sa charācaram. Now here I am, under my direction, the prakriti, the nature, material nature is working. So you accept, then your business is done. And Krishna gave evidences how he is controlling the nature. When Krishna was 7 years old, he lifted one big mountain on his finger. That means our understanding is that there is law of gravitation. By law of gravitation, such a big mountain, it cannot stay in one man's finger. That is our calculation. But he did it. That means he counteracted the law of gravitation. That is God. So, if you believe this, then you know God immediately. There is no difficulty. Just like if the child is born, my dear child, do not touch fire. It will burn you. So if the child accepts, then he gets the perfect knowledge immediately. If the child does not accept, he wants to make experiment, then he will burn his finger. So, our process of knowledge, we should take from the supreme authority. Then we save time for research work. That is Krishna consciousness movement. We take perfect knowledge from Krishna. I may be imperfect, just like child is imperfect. I may be imperfect, you may be imperfect. But if you take the perfect knowledge from the supreme perfect, then your knowledge is perfect. That is the process. This is called avarohopantha, knowledge coming, deductive knowledge. So everything is there, and if you like to take advantage of this movement, make your life perfect, go back to home, back to Godhead, then fully utilize the center, our Melbourne center, come here, read our books and argue, try to understand with your full knowledge, no blindly acceptance. There is reason, there is argument, there is philosophy, there is science, everything is there. And if you accept that simply by chanting I shall realize, that is also allowed. Both ways. If you accept this simple process, the chant Hare Krishna and realize God, that is also fact. And if you think, what is this nonsense, chanting Hare Krishna, then you read books. Both ways we are prepared. Come and take advantage of this moment. Thank you very much.
Jai! Jai! Jai!
Lord Brahma rides on a swan, Mahamsa. Is this, we take this to mean that it's a real swan, or is it something?